Hi guys, today I'll be running different currents through solid wires, 2.5 and 4 square millimeters. We'll compare their heating and voltage drop. For tests over a wide range, I installed the 32 amp circuit breaker. Let's get started. The choice between a 2.5 and 4 square millimeters cross section usually comes up when dealing with separate high power consumers or long group socket lines. Sixteen amps is the typical continuous current for socket lines. Don't forget to multiply the voltage drop and losses by 2 in single phase lines. Let's see what happens at 20 amps. At a continuous current of 20 amps, the heating of a 2.5 square millimeters wire exceeds 40 degrees Celsius. That means the wire will be quite warm. If a 16 amp circuit breaker is installed, a current of 25 amps will cause it to trip after a few minutes. At continuous currents, the temperature difference is about 10 degrees Celsius. At 32 amps, the voltage drop and losses in a 2.5 square millimeter wire are significant. Prolonged heating of a 2.5 square millimeter wire is close to 70 degrees Celsius. Let's see whether the single 4 square millimeter wire will overheat at 40 amps. Well, the 4 square millimeter wire is still within acceptable limits. So, at all currents with the 2.5 square millimeter cross section, the voltage drop and losses will be 60 to 70% higher. With the fast shutdown at 300 amps, the wire temperature increased by only 1 degree. 200 amps lasted for 2 seconds, and the temperature rise was 40-50 degrees Celsius respectively. Let's look at the cooling process. 120 amps lasted longer, so the temperature rise was a few degrees higher.